You pull it back and fire. Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. This video is 10 origami action models in one, starring number one, Kermit the Frog.
Hi everyone, my name is Kermit. I have to find Miss Piggy now. See you in a bit.
Number two, it's a boat that floats, and the boat is wearing a bow tie. Get it? A boat tie. Number three, shark boat. Dun 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 dun. And it has boat eyes. Bow tie and boat eyes. And it will eat you. Yum, 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 yum. Number four, painful pincher's bird beak. It'll pinch your finger, and if it pinches your lip, it'll hurt. So don't do that. It can even pick up a watch. Number five, the balancing guinea pig. And when you blow on it, it plays dead. Number six, super catapult guinea pig. And it comes with a couple slots for micro SD cards or whatever else you want to fire. Just pull it back and whoosh. Number seven, butterfly mouth chomping swamp monster. And it even makes a chomping noise. Number eight is the dizzy monster rubber ducky hat. And it even comes with a bow. And why is it dizzy? Because when you put it on your finger, it can spin. Number nine, the fidget blow spinner. And number 10, the super duper mad cow. Watch out, it's gonna bonk ya. And that's all.
Well, wasn't that neat? Wanna learn how to fold this? Ready, set, here goes.
All right, so for this Kermit the Frog, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of commie. And let's begin white side up and fold in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. And now unfold and fold the bottom edge to the crease. And rotate and fold this edge to here. Okay, let's rotate and fold this edge to the middle, like this. And repeat on this side. And rotate and repeat on this side. Okay, now unfold this flap. And now we're going to make a reverse fold. So open here slightly, and we're going to push this corner in. So first we need to reverse this crease, so you can pinch it if you want. And that'll make it a little bit easier to just push it in. And once it's in like that, bring the flap back down. Like that. There's one reverse fold complete. Now we need to repeat on these three flaps. So let's do this flap first. Unfold and open it. And we're going to push this in like this and bring the flap back down. Okay, those two are complete. Rotate and let's do these two. So unfold and open, push it in, pinch, and bring it back down. And one last reverse fold. Okay, so this here is called a pig base, but we are not going to make a pig. Let's rotate and fold in half. Make sure that the two flaps are on top. And rotate, and now fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with the top edge. And we just need to fold from this corner to here, like that, and unfold and rotate. And now fold this side up, and we're going to repeat. Fold this edge to here. And once again, just fold from the corner to here. And unfold. Now we're going to make both folds at the same time. So we bring it up like this and pinch here. And now fold this up. And as you fold it up, just pinch the layers so that they hold together and don't slide. Okay. And let's take the three flaps, one, two, three, and fold them down. And once again, hold on to them so that they stay together as they fold down, like that. Okay, now turn over, and we're going to repeat on this side. So fold this edge to here, fold from here to here, unfold, and rotate, and fold this flap so that this edge aligns with this edge. And unfold and fold both flaps at the same time and fold it down this way and fold it up. Okay, so this is what it should look like. Now let's lift this flap up so that it sticks straight up, or rather these three flaps, and do the same on this side. So bring these flaps like this. And now open the mouth right here. There's the mouth, hi. So it's like this. We have a square now. Let's fold the square diagonally in half like this. And here we have a shape that looks like this. Okay, now we're going to rabbit ear this front flap. So fold this edge to the crease, and you just need to fold from this point to the crease right there. And unfold, and now fold it so that this edge aligns with this crease. And unfold, and now we're going to make both folds at the same time. So bring it up like this, pinch the corner, and there's our rabbit ear. Let's flatten it to the right and to the left. And now turn over, and let's repeat on this side. Okay, and let's fold it down. Try to hold it together so that the layers don't slide. And up. Okay, so this is what it looks like. Now, let's make this stick up like this and make this rabbit ear stick out as well. And now, bring this front flap down and bring this flap down and turn over and repeat on this side. Bring this flap down and this flap down and flatten them well. Okay, so like this, this is actually a bonus model. Even like this, it's a pretty cool model. Can you see what it is? It's a fidget spinner. You hold right here and just blow here. And if it's too big for your hand, then you can do it like this. And this was actually the original model I was trying to make. I was trying to make a fidget spinner. And so everyone who says that this is a waste of time will look at all of the models that this became. So anyway, you can also transform the sides into hearts by folding the corners back. I'm not going to do it on this model, but I did it right here. And then it can be a fidget spinner like this. Just blow into here. Isn't that pretty cool? And this model can also be a heart slider creature. Here's the arms and here's the mouth. It can go like this, or it can thump like this. And it can also slide along the table. The object of the game is to try to slide the heart along the table without making it fall down. So be gentle. Like that. But those are all extras, not part of the tin. And here's another extra. You just pull the two flaps apart, push this point in, and there's a talking mouth. And it has a heart on it. Yes, it can be the talking heart. Or you could pull these forward so that it has ears or something, like a fox. Okay, back to the model already scheduled. All right, so we're like this. Now let's fold this flap so that it sticks up, and let's squash it. So reach in here with your finger, open the pocket, and squash it down so that it's even. And how can you tell that it's even? What you want to do is turn over and adjust the position so that this crease aligns with this point and flatten it. All right, so it's like this. Now let's turn over and fold this flap over so that you're folding it towards these flaps. And now fold this flap up like this. And fold this flap over. And now let's fold this flap up so that the fold aligns with this edge. And you can let this white flap slide out like that and flatten. So that's what it should look like. And now turn over, and we're going to repeat on this side. So let's fold this flap up so that it sticks up and reach in and squash it. And to make sure that we have the squash even, turn over and make sure that the crease aligns with this point, like that. And now let's turn back over and fold this flap towards these points. I guess it's just one point now. And like this, and fold this flap up, and fold this flap over, and fold this flap up so that it aligns with this edge, and let the white flap slip out like that. And we're done with this whole side. So now let's work on this part. This is the lower jaw, and here we have the bow tie. And now we're going to work on the two eyes. So let's fold this flap down to here. And fold it up about like this. We want this length to be equal to this length. And the way we can test that is by folding this over like this. So these two flaps, they overlap like this. And you can just fiddle with the folds until you have thirds like that. You might need to slide it a little bit more or less so that from the side, you see, they overlap like that. And they should cross right here. at this fold. Okay, let's unfold this flap and open this flap and squash it. So it's like that, and fold this flap so it's a square. And let's unfold this flap, and we're going to refold it so that this square lands on this crease, and we want the diagonal of the square to land on the crease, so it's like that, and make the fold. Okay, and we'll make it round or rather octagonal later, but let's first do the other eye. So turn over and let's fold down like this. And we already have our crease, so fold it up along the existing crease and open and squash it. And open and make the square and bring the flap up and fold it. You can use this as a guide, or actually the crease is better. Okay, so the eye is right on the crease, and now we're going to make it octagonal. Now this is a little bit difficult and it's not really necessary. I mean, if you are okay with the square eye, well, this is the frog like that. You just push that in and there you have it. But to make it octagonal, this is what we're going to do. Let's be a little bit exact on the first flap. So this flap, let's fold it up like this. And the camera's having a little trouble. Okay, so it's like that. And now we're going to fold this flap to this point where the crease hits that edge. So this is really small. Just carefully fold it over to that point right there. That's tricky. Okay, and now bring this flap down. So here we have the first side of the octagon. And now you can just fold these two flaps behind so that they're the same. If you want, you could first make the pre-crease, but I'm not gonna go through that. Just eyeball it. Get it? Eyeball it. Okay. There we go. There's the second side of the octagon. And here's the third side. And for the fourth side, this is a little tricky. What we're going to do is open here. We're going to kind of pretend like we're reverse folding this point. So we're pushing it in like that, so that this edge aligns with this crease. And now we're going to flatten it as we make the fourth edge of the octagon. Well, I guess it's kind of like the eighth edge, because octagon has eight edges, but hopefully you know what I mean. The fourth fold of the eye, because these other sides of the octagon don't have folds in them. And even though I tried to be exact, it still wasn't exact like an octagon should be, but good enough, I guess. Okay, good enough. All right, now I'm going to make the other octagon, and I think I'm going to just speed through this. Okay, so there we have the other eye, and there's the frog. and flatten it again. Now one more fold that will just make it look a little bit better, I think, is folding this edge behind. So let's fold it over and fold this edge so that it aligns with here. And fold it back. Oops, I folded the eye in half. Okay, so it's like that. And turn over and repeat on this side. Just fold this edge behind. Like that. All right, so like this, we just push in the middle and pull on the sides, and there we have Kermit. Now, if you like it like that, I guess it's okay. I mean, it's nice how the edges come together so nicely. But I think it looks a little bit better with a shorter snout. And it also will end up making some of the other models look nicer as well. And it also might look a little bit more like Kermit. So what you do is take this corner and bring it up to this point. Don't make the whole fold. Just make a little pinch mark right there. And now fold this point down to here. And you can press that flat. And now you can round this out a little bit by folding this in about like that to taste. And same on this side. And now bring this back down and flatten it. So there's the upper jaw. And now for the lower jaw, let's do the same thing, but you might want to make it even shorter. So let's bring this to here, make your little pinch mark. And this time, instead of folding to that part, let's go a little bit further. That'll shorten the jaw. So it's like this. And now round it out to taste by folding this corner in, and same on this side. And bring this back like it was. So here is a little shorter jaw, and push this in. And there we have Kermit. And you can just kind of adjust it to taste. Hopefully you can get it so that the edges come together like this. So like that, you're done. Now, if you want to put pupils on the eyes, then this is what you want to do. You want to make a fold that goes from this point to here. And when you do that, you see this is the pupil. And let's do the same thing on this side. So we're going from this point to here. So it's like that. And that just makes it look a little bit more alive, I'd say. But for the actual 10 different models, or the other 9 rather, I think it's better just to unfold them like this. Okay, so here we have the shorter snout Kermit the Frog. And let's get the bow tie so that it looks nice. Just pull out the corners. And there's Kermit the Frog. And you can just kind of adjust the edges a little bit so that they hit up against each other, like that. So there is number 1, Kermit the Talking Frog with the bow tie. All right, now for number 2, the boats. So let's open this flap right here and open here. And now we're going to fold them together. So we just need to push this part in like this, and bring the two arms so that they come together. And this is the boat. And it's a boat with a boat tie. Get it? Boat tie, boat tie. And that's number 2. And it's also a shark boat. You see, here's the shark head and the shark fin. Dun, 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 dun. And it's a shark boat with boat eyes. Get it? Boat eyes, bow ties. We have a bow tie and we have boat eyes. So that's number three. And it will eat you. Yum, 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 yum. Or maybe it'll eat you like this. Yum, 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 yum. And this is actually the bird beak, the pincers. And to make the pincers extra strong, if you pull open this, then we have number four, painful pincers bird beak. It'll pinch your finger, and if it pinches your lip, it'll hurt. So don't do that. It can even pick up a watch. All right, so there's number four, the bird beak. And for number five, the balancing guinea pig. Well, here's the head of the guinea pig. There's the eye. We want to flatten here and bring these flaps down like this. And the object is to try to balance the model on these three flaps. And this takes a little bit of fidgeting around. You want to try to elongate this just enough so that it balances like that. Ooh, I got it. And now the guinea pig is going to play dead. Blow on it, and it plays dead. Now to go from the balancing guinea pig to the super catapult guinea pig, you just push in the top and pull it back and foie. And there's the catapult. And you put whatever you want inside. And pull it back and let go. Okay, so for the butterfly mouth chomping swamp monster, what you want to do is open it like this. Oops, I guess I could use some more light. Open it like this and just push these two points so that they poke in like that. And now you can form the butterfly. These are the teeth of the swamp monster. And you just push together like this. From the back side, this is what it looks like. And it should make like a funny sound if you fiddle around with it. A chomping sound, I guess. So that is the butterfly swamp monster. And you can go like this so that it's has ears, or down like this so it has like gills or something, I don't know, from the side view. Now as far as the sound is concerned, it's kind of a hit and miss, but there's just a lot of possibilities for sound. I don't exactly know how the sound is happening, but it's happened three out of the last four times that I made the model, so hopefully if you fiddle with this back flap, you'll figure out how to make it make some sound. And that's the butterfly mouth chomping swamp monster. All right, so to go from the butterfly mouth chomping swamp monster to the dizzy monster rubber ducky hat, what you do is you just open these flaps, just pull them out, and there you have the hat. And stick it on the rubber ducky or whatever other small head that you can find. And there is the rubber ducky hat, and it has a bow right there. And it is the monster, and also it's dizzy because when you put it on your finger, it can spin around like this. There you have it. All right, so to go from the dizzy monster rubber ducky hat to the blow fidget spinner, you want to flatten this out and bring these two flaps together, and then rabbit ear this one. Make sure it goes under these flaps, and turn over and rabbit ear this one. So we're back to where we were, where we pressed this in, and there is Kermit. And you just flatten it like this, and hold it between your fingers like this, and just blow on here and here. So we're just blowing on the side of it. And if your hand is too small for that, then you can try to do it with two hands like this. Like that. One last thing about this blow spinner is that it can also be used as an oscillation spinner. You just want to get the right frequency, and it's like that. Now this is kind of challenging, and the trick to it is to realize where the center of gravity is. So if you hold it like this and let it fall, you see it goes down like that. And as with the other oscillations fidget spinners, you want one finger on top and one finger on the bottom. And then you just want to imagine that the ball is out here and you're swinging that ball around like this. So it's, and you just have to find that right frequency. And yeah, you might want to refold the model so that these points are sharp. And you might also want to fold it a little bit smaller so that it'll fit your hands. And the other thing is that you can just pull this out a little bit so that the center of gravity is clearly down like this. And that'll make it a little bit easier. But it's very challenging, so if you can't do that, don't feel bad. I can barely do it. All right, so to turn this fidget spinner into this mad cow, this is what you want to do. You want to unfold the rabbit ears. So unfold on this side and turn over and unfold the rabbit ear on this side. And now all you have to do is open this part right here. And just like this, you see it's sort of like a cow. And you just move it back and forth like this, or you move it back and forth like that, just by sliding your fingers back and forth like that. But if you want to make it look a lot more like a cow, what you should do is unfold these two flaps so that the ears stick up, and now fold them forward so that the fold aligns with this edge. And this edge and this edge align, and do the same on the back. And then also you should unfold these flaps, and I'd say the snout needs to be a little bit longer. So unfold this flap and fold that flap in just about that much. That looks pretty good. And then open up the ears so it's like that, and same on the other side. And here we have what looks like, well, somewhat like a cow. And here's the mad cow. Mm-hmm. Ah. You just need to make sound effects to make it extra mad. And then to make it bop, you just hold up like this and you can make sound effects. And there you have it. And that's number 10. And bring back Kermit. Owen, might want to shorten the snout again. And there is Kermit. And we can bring the pupils back.
Bye, guys.
Now, a couple more tips with Kermit is that if you notice that the mouth is doing this kind of thing, then you just need to make sure that this flap goes over this edge. So just tuck it over the edge and tuck this flap over the edge and hold it right about here. That way the edges will come together nicely like that. And with the eyes, if you want to lift up the eye, just lift up the eye part. Don't lift up this flap. Otherwise you'll have that same problem. So you can lift up the eye like this. So that's what it looks like, and that'll look pretty good from the front. And same on this side. Don't lift up the whole flap, just lift up the eye flap. And now, look how this looks. Yeah, you just have to make sure that this flap stays over the edge. And same on this side. And there you have it.
Okay, well, I hope you guys enjoyed that. And I have a question. Why are there so many songs about rainbows? And what's on the other side? And one more thing. I'm not really a frog. I'm a chicken.
What?